Good morning all. In this video, I am going to take the session Uniform Resource Locators and Multipurpose Internet Mail Extension. First topic, URLs. Uniform Resource Locator is something that you must be knowing about, or you must be using it for going to a particular website. It's the address of a specific web page or file on internet. Every web page have unique URL. In other words, it is the mechanism used by browser to retrieve any published resource on the web. It's also known as internet address or web address. URLs are meant to be easy for people to remember and to use. A URL that starts with https://// indicates that you are on a secure site. Some example of URLs are http://www.google.com, https://www.tutorialpoint.com, which is the URL for the Tutorial Point website. URLs are used to identify documents on the internet. All the URLs have the same general format. Scheme : object address means URL begin with the scheme, which tells the browser what type of address it is. The scheme is often a common protocol. Common scheme include HTTP, FTP, Telnet, mail to file and all. HTTP supports the web and is used to request and send extensible hypertext markup language documents. In case of HTTP, object address form of URL is http://, fully qualified domain name, / path to document. The file protocol means that the document resides on the machine running the browser. In case of file, object address form of URL is file://, path to document. Host name, name of the server may include a port number. Default port is 80. http://www.xyz.org is an example. The main part of URL is domain name, which will tell you the company that run the site, such as Amazon and Facebook. The domain name begin with the subdomain. For example, www.facebook.com is one of the common example, www. And the rightmost part of the domain name is top level domain. For example, .com. And many other top level domain is used for education institution is .edu and organizations such as .org. After the domain name, URL may have file path, which direct to browser to a specific page within the site. While the domain is the name of the website, a URL will lead to any one of the page within the website. Every URL contains a domain name as well as other components needed to locate the specific page. URLs cannot include spaces or any of a collection of other special characters such as semicolon or colons. To include space or special character, the character must be coded as modsign followed by 2D hexadecimal ASCII code of char. For example, if domain name is san space jaws, then san mod 20 jaws. 20 is a hexa code for space. In Unix server, path is specified with /, and in Windows server /. A URL need not include all directories on the path. A path that includes all directories along the way is called a complete path. For example of complete path is http://www.abc.com/files/images/logo.jpg. In most cases, the path to the document is related to some base path that is specified in the configuration file of the server. Such a path is called partial path. For example, if the server's configuration specifies that the root directory for files it can serve is file/images, the previous URL is specified as http://www.abc.com/logo.jpg. If the document path ends with a slash, it means it's a directory. For example, http://www.abc.com/departments/. Sometimes a directory is specified, but its name is not given. For example, http://www.abc.com/. The server then searches the top level of the directory in which servable documents are normally stored for something it recognizes as a home page. By convention, this page is often a file named index.html. The home page usually includes links that allow the user to find other related servable files on the server. If the directory docs not have a file that the server recognizes as being a home page, a directory listing is constructed and returned to the browser. Next session is multipurpose internet mail extensions, main. Browser needs some way of determining the format of the document it receives from a web server. Without knowing the form of document, browsers would not be able to render it because different document format require different rendering software. The form of the document are specified with MAME. MAME is an internet standard that specifies the data format of the content that the server is transmitting to the browser so that programs can interpret the data correctly. It is used to specify to the browser the format of a file returned by the server. Web server attaches MAME format specification to the beginning of the document to provide to a browser. When browser receives the document, it uses MAME format, means multipurpose internet mail extension format specification, to determine what to do with the document. For example, if content is text, then MAME code tells the browser that it is a text. And taking another example, if the content is a sound, then browser will choose a program to access the transmitted sound. Type specifications. Form is type/subtype. Examples. Common MIME type are text, /plain, text/HTML, image/GIF, image/JPEG. Common MIME types are text, image, video, and subtypes are text such as plain, HTML, and for images such as GIF, JPEG, and videos such as MPEG, QuickTime. Server gets type from the requested file name's extension. .html tells the server that it should attach text/html to the document before sending it to the browser. HTML slash HTML. text/html. Browser gets the type explicitly from the server. Next, experimental document types. When the main type is either text or image, the browser runs. When the main type is either text or image, the browser renders the document without any problem. However, if the type is video or audio, it cannot render the document. It has to take the help of other software, for example, like media player, like that. These softwares are called helper application or plugins. The name of an experimental subtype begins with example x. Example video/x-ms-video. If browser does not have helper application plug in to render a document, an error message is displayed. Every browser has a set of main specification file type it can handle. All browsers can deal with, for example, text/plain unformatted text and text/html means HTML file. Thank you.